क्लासिक इंडियन एपिक्स सच एज द महाभारत द रामायण एंड द पुराणास रेफर टू डाइवर्स काइंड ऑफ बींग्स डिस्क्राइबिंग दैम एज सुपर ह्यूमन और सब ह्यूमन एंड अदर वर्ल्डली एक्स्ट्रा टेरेस्ट्रियल्स दैट केम टू इनहैबिट द लिविंग वर्ल्ड. मैनी ऑफ दीज ट्राइब्स हैव अ स्ट्रॉन्ग हिस्टोरिकल बेसिस वाइल द सुपर नेचुरल एंड फैंटास्टिक एस्पेक्ट्स आर कंसिडर्ड टू बी लिटररी स्पेक्यूलेशन. From a historical point of view, these exotic tribes simply may have been tribes that did not interact frequently with a mainstream culture, so that the knowledge of them was very limited, which spurred the invention of fables about them. In any case, Hindu religious texts describe these tribes as having a profound influence on Hindu culture, but remaining separate from the said culture. Perhaps due to their geographic isolation from the rest of the world. The texts describe the tribe's bases as ranging from high mountains to deep forests, or they were civilizations beyond the mainstream Indian civilization which prevailed in the plains of Saraswati, Sindhu, and the Ganges.
Gandharvas are described as fierce warriors who could challenge even the great Kshatriya warriors. They were also skilled in art, music, and dance. Some Gandharva tribes were allied with the Devas and sometimes with Yakshas. They inhabited the land to the north of Kailasa, close to the Deva territories. They might have spread to the Saraswati River, seen by Balarama during his pilgrimage over Saraswati. The Ramayana mentions a Gandharva kingdom named as Sailusa, near the mouth of the river Ganga.
The Yaksha were a tribe living in the area surrounding the Kailasha range of the Himalayas. Their king, Vaishravana or Kubera, was a worshipper of Shiva, whose abode is thought to be Kailas. According to Ramayana, Kubera established or rebuilt the kingdom of Lanka, which is now known as Sri Lanka, and it is inhabited with the Yaksha people. Later on, Kuber's stepbrother, Ravana, because they had the same father, Vaishnava, took over Sri Lanka upon their father's request. Kuber moved to the region near Kailasa mountain in the Himalayas. In another passage in Mahabharata, there is a mention of Pandava brothers Bhima, Arjun, Nakul and Sahadev drinking from a pond governed by a Yaksha. They became unconscious after drinking the pond water. Then the eldest brother Yudhishthira answers the dharma related questions asked by a yaksha and gets his brother's life back.
The Kinnaras are a tribe often spoken of along with the Gandharvas and Yakshas. The epic Mahabharata and the Puranas describe regions of the north of the Himalayas as the abode of Kinnaras. Kinnaras means what a strange man. Sometimes it is also used as a respectable term for the third gender humans. They were exceptional in arts and music, though they are also considered to be physically very powerful and beautiful. Arjuna in Mahabharata was cursed to become a Kinnara for the last year of the Pandavas' exile. There is now a district named Kinnaur in Himachal Pradesh, which is thought to be the domain of the Kinnara tribes. People of this district called themselves Kinnaurs. Puranas mention an asura with a horse head who was known as Hayagriva in Sanskrit, means the horse-headed one. Haya is horse and Griva is neck. This asura was killed by an incarnation of Lord Vishnu who took the similar form of the horse-headed human figure. Egyptian sculptures also see horse-headed figures of the warriors employing an elongated face mask which resembles the head of the horse. This region was also the abode of a tribe of people called Kambojas. They were fierce warriors skilled in horse rides and horse warfare. Some of them were robber tribes who invaded village settlements by raiding them using their skilled cavalry forces.
Rakshasas were described to have large bodies, probably due to their continuous life in cold climates over snow-covered mountains. There is a highly speculative hypothesis based on the genographic project that many species of humans coexisted, all of them in a culturally evolved state. Rakshasas could be one of these species of humans, like the Neanderthals of Europe and other places in Asia where the temperature was very low, like for example the Himalayan region. They were reduced to small pockets like the high Himalayas and the cool mountains of Sri Lanka, with their social networks steadily shrinking. Another view is that the Rakshasas were normal humans who actually followed a certain religious way, like Vyamaraksham, aggression and protection of spiritual life, as opposed to Yakshas who followed Vyamayaksham, enjoyment and pleasure, which ignored the spiritual pursuits. There were several other such religious groups, also known as the Dasas, which describes service and submission. Divodasa and Sudasa are called Aryan emperors and even heroes of Rigveda, whose religious beliefs were quite different. Many a times, entire tribes or localities were painted with names.
Nagas were a group of people spread throughout India during the period of the epic Mahabharata. The demigod tribe called Suparnas, to which Garuda belonged, were arch-rivals of the Nagas. The Naga clans in Kerala and Kashmir seems to be the original and indigenous abode of all of them. Places like Thiruvananthapuram in Kerala and Anantanag in Kashmir attest this to be true. The great serpent Ananta was the first among all the Naga kings. Thiruvananthapuram is also called as the abode of the great serpent Ananta. The second Naga chief Vasuki had the kingdom near Kailasa, hence connection of Vasuki with the Lord Shiva. The third chief Takshaka was the ruler of Takshashila. Takshashila is named after Taksha, son of Bharat and nephew to Ram. The kingdoms of the other Nagas like Karkotaka and Airavat near Iravati River, one among the five rivers of the Punjab. The kingdom of Aryaka was on the Ganga River basin. His great-grandchildren included Krishna and Pandavas.
The Suparnas, also known as the Garudas, were probably the falcon-worshipping or falcon-rearing tribes who conquered the Naga territories of northwest India. They were arch-rivals of the Nagas. Garuda was a famous Suparna. They could fly in the air without using an aircraft. Some literature tells that they had wings like those of angels, while some believe they were birds like the hawk or the eagle. Some think that they were a race of intelligent dragons in the family of dinosaurs that became extinct during the dawn of human civilization. Yet another view is that Nagas and Garudas were the two rival factions of the same tribe. Mahabharata also supports this view, since it describes the two races originating from two mothers who were actually sisters. There were many other exotic tribes of ancient India, and we will discuss each of them in detail in our other videos. So stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Banthanah Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.